In this video, we'll be seeing how to read and write data into a database from Android. We'll be using the Volley library for this. First of all, we have to add the dependencies. For that, go to the URL. The URL will be in the description. And copy the dependency. And go to your project, Gradle Scripts. Choose the second one, which is the app, your app. Then type the dependency section. Paste the dependency for the Volley. And click sync now. Now after synchronization, you could just close the Gradle file. Now we have added Volley to our project successfully. After that, you have to go to the URL and click the simple request and copy the Java code. Now paste it inside the onCreate method. Now remove the comments. Now here we have to import all the classes. Press Alt Enter. After importing all the classes, you could see that we have added a text view and the ID is text. Now this is to show the result to the view part. Okay, so for that, go to the resources, layout, activity main.xml, and then go to the split, and here we have a text view by default. Or if you don't have, just add a text view, then just give it an ID, text. Okay, now we have added a text view with the ID text. Now if you want to make it a little bit larger, just set the text size to 5 SP. Okay, that's all. Now you can just go to the Java. Here you can see a variable URL. Here we have to mention our URL from which we are reading or writing the data into or from. Okay, so I will show the read operation first. So I have created two PHP files, that is read.php and write.php. Okay, now read.php just prints this success message. Okay, and the write.php prints success if we passed a variable, otherwise it will show error. Okay, so first of all, let's show the read option. So I have uploaded this to my server and the URL is this one. Copy this URL and paste this here. Okay, now we have pasted the URL. Now we are demonstrating the read operation. You can just remove this substring and just keep it like this. Okay. Now we have to add the internet permission. So here type users permission and internet. Just press Alt Enter and it will collapse. Okay. So we need the permission for internet. That's all. After that, just close the manifest. And then you could just run the application. Now you can see the application is on. And now you can see that the response success has been received. So this shows that our read has been successfully done. Okay, after that, one of the main thing you have to note is that you have to add the permission for internet in the manifest. Otherwise it will show error. Okay. So now let's go to the write operation. For that, I have uploaded the file and This is the URL. Now just change this URL and paste this. Now if you run this, you could see an error. Now this error message is because we haven't passed any parameters along with the URL. Now since we are using get method here, we could pass the variables like aram equal to, now we have to pass the value, just give something like abc. Now we have passed the parameter with the value abc. Okay, now let's run the application. Now you can see the response is success. Since we have used the request method, we could use either get or post. If we are just mentioning get here, then we could only use the get method. Then the post method will not work. So just keeping it to request. Now I will show how to implement the post method. To implement the post method, you have to make the method as post here, and then you have to come here and open a curly braces, and here we have to pass the values. Just create a function getParam with returning the value that is a map with two strings. Okay, now here we have to create another map with string comma string. Name it param equal to new hash map. Okay, that's all. Now we have to add the value. For that, param dot put. Now our field name is like param. Then the value will be, let it be abc. Okay, now we have passed the value. Now return param. Okay, that's all. So now this param is the variable. Okay, now let's make it param variable. Okay, in order to avoid confusion for you. Okay, so here we have again passed this get talk, so remove that because we are using post method. Okay, so we don't need the values after the URL. Now let's run the application. Now you can see the response is success. Now hope you understand how to implement both the get and post method, and also how to read the value from a database. Okay, now how to read this from a database. So here I have just shown the connection between the PHP API and the Android. Now here you could just write any scripts that will either read or either allow you to write into the database. Okay, so that's up to you. Just I have shown how to do that. Hope this video was helpful for you. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for more such videos.